Former Kenya Rugby Union Vice Chair and Director Sasha Mutai is a top candidate for the chairmanship at the Kenya Rugby Union election set for March and has outlined his key priorities that he seeks to implement should he be elected boss of the Ngong Road-based Federation.
Kenya Rugby Union in the last few years has just been going down, has lost credibility with the sponsors, with the players. So I think the time is right now to actually clean up stuff and bring back rugby the way it's supposed to be. Right now, it's a whole mess at the Kenya Rugby Union. Credibility is gone, sponsors have left, players do not trust the union, and the players are a very important part of rugby. You can't have rugby without the players. The fans are also disappointed at the way the union has been run. It's lack of leadership, so I'm coming to provide that leadership that is needed to bring back rugby where it's supposed to be.
Ahead of the HSBC Sevens World Series third and fourth legs set for this weekend and next weekend in Hamilton and Sydney, that have seen several heavyweights excluded from the Paul Murunga assembled team, Mutai exonerated senior players from the blame of not signing contracts. Meanwhile, the National 15's team Simbas will this year be involved in the rebranded Africa Gold Cup as they seek to atone for their 2018 undoings when they failed to book a slot at the 2019 Rugby World Cup in Japan. Starting July 2019, the Gold Cup will adopt a new format where the eight sides will be divided in two pools of four each, with matches of each pool taking place in one country in a round-robin format. Winners of each pool will then face off in the final, and the team with the better point tally in the preliminary will host the decider in November. At the same time, the National Under-20 team will also be in action in 2019 as they seek to wrestle the Bats Cup from holders Namibia and book a slot at the 2019 Junior World Rugby Trophy in Brazil.